time for Voices in Your Head, the Back to School Edition. And here they are, fresh from a summer vacation spent pleasuring themselves, Professor Barry P. Cook and Principal Tom Izzo.
Hi, welcome to this edition of Voices in Your Head. I'm Barry P. Cook. And I'm Rod Stiffington. See that? You're standing in for Tom Izzo.
It's September already.
Yes, it is. Barry,
summer's gone.
The air is just a little bit cooler. The fall foliage is turning a bitter shade of crimson. And here we are in September once again.
Kids start school day.
That's right. Kids are back to school. And of course, this is our 27th year on the air. Seth, isn't it?
Yeah, it's got to be close to that.
We're filming live from Iraq. This is the area where people are kidnapped and beheaded.
They let those new guys
They did. If you look back at the show, I'll flip us on some random Sunday. I swear to God, the video quality looks like the terrorists are using the same technology as we are to film all of their beheading videos.
Maybe we could be using the same thing.
Like one of these days, one of these shows, you're going to see some chic guy standing behind us, you know, the turban wrapped around his head, holding an AK-47.
I don't know. Something like that. Then we'll know we've made it. Here, you can hold on to this.
Believe it or not, it's just me!
And what's going on? You know what is on the news like every 2 seconds now is that JonBenet situation.
Yeah. Yeah,
it was... That guy Carr.
Jean-Marc Carr. He was, I guess he confessed that he killed JonBenet.
What a sick bastard.
And for some reason, he was taken at his word.
Yeah, well, I think they arrested him to investigate. I mean, here's the guy confessing to the thing. You got to look into it, you know?
Right.
But just yesterday, they decided not to prosecute, I guess.
Well, obviously, there's nothing linking him to the scene.
Yeah.
You know, other than his own crazy rantings.
Yeah.
And I guess, you know, they did a DNA test.
Right. Yes.
And, you know.
No match.
They said that the DNA sample in the underwear that they had, they bought a new pair of that same underwear, a new package, opened the package, and that same DNA sample was in the underwear. So they're thinking that this sample was from, like, some Taiwanese factory worker who, you know, it's not, I don't believe it's semen.
Yeah.
It's some sort of, like, fibery... They don't know what it is. It's just some, you know, some... You know, Barry, you worked at a factory for 10 years. When you're manufacturing little girls' underwear, I guess you're threading it, and, you know, you're sweating all over it.
Yeah, yeah.
There's some DNA evidence that's going to get left.
Sniffing it before it goes in the package.
Oh, just God.
No, just kidding. But, my thing, though, is, you know what, and they're extraditing it back to California now, probably. And,
right.
You know,
but this guy, he wasted everybody's time.
Yeah.
He wasted the taxpayers' money.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, he took a first-class flight back to the U.S.
I don't know how much of a waste it is.
He was eating shrimp, drinking champagne.
But they are going to get
our tax dollars.
Yeah.
He's going to do a year for child pornography. Well, there's the thing. If he goes to jail and he's, you know, in the general population,
They'll kill him.
He's going to be killed.
Oh, yeah. They'll kill him. He's a sick bastard.
But do you look at him, though, Barry? He kind of has... I think he's taken some sort of estrogen hormone injections.
Yeah, he's got a female thing
he's
going
got some,
on. Yeah,
he's got some little...
We'll put a picture up, but he's definitely... He's a sick-looking bastard.
He's got some mosquito bite. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Speaking of pencil-neck geeks, man.
Yeah.
This...
Just looking at this guy made me want to hurl. Never mind what he did.
Just chilling. You look at the guy, your testicles shrink back into your body.
Yeah.
You know, you...
So hopefully they're going to get him on. And, you know, they found him in Taiwan, which, of course, you know, the sex traffic capital of the world over there.
You know,
they traffic in sex.
Exactly.
24/7, 365.
Taiwan, it's such a disgusting place.
Oh, yeah.
It's a scourge of humanity. It's where people go, sick people go, who want to have sex with children.
Yeah.
That's where you go.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that's reason alone to just obliterate that place off the face of the earth.
Crazy bastard.
You screw the UN.
Yeah.
Screw, we'll just go there and crack that. No. If a place is, you know, contributing to having, where people can go and have sex with children.
They have tours.
It's just not right.
No. So, I don't know. Let's just hope that something, I still think the mother had something to do with it.
It is.
You know,
something really not right there with that family.
I really do.
You know, investigators say, experts say, you know, this is a 10-year-old case. It's somebody either involved with the family, if not the family themselves.
Right. Yep, I think so. So we'll see how this plays out. I don't think they're ever going to figure out.
No, the case will never be solved.
Yeah. Hopefully they kill this guy in prison like he did, because he's definitely not fit for human life.
Yeah, you know.
Sicko.
Anybody who finds pleasure in children having sex just needs to be sent to prison with the toughest crackhead ball breaking prison bastards that, you know, they're gonna rape him and then they're gonna beat him and then they're gonna rape him some more.
He's definitely out of his mind because they were playing tonight on Entertainment Tonight some clips of phone calls that he made, like, to that news guy.
Yeah.
And he was saying stuff about she had a lover and the lover was there when she died. It was just crazy. In fact,
studied the case.
He was a sicko.
End over end. He poured through every shred of evidence that was involved in the case.
Crazy man.
And he was just obsessed with it.
Yeah.
Obsessed.
He's definitely not.
But,
right.
No. But, I don't know. It just, you know, and it's going to be dragged through the media again.
Yeah.
You know, unfortunate. Unfortunate that this had to happen.
What do you think of the whole thing with Tom Cruise and Paramount Pictures?
I'll tell you what I think of it,
Gary. I mean, you know, there are people saying that, you know, Sumner Redstone shouldn't have come out and said what he said. They just should have come up with some polite reason. And there are people saying that that's a cover. Or they just fired him for other reasons.
More power to Sumner. You know why? Tom Cruise, clearly there's something not right.
Yeah.
He's going on the Today Show saying medicine and psychiatry aren't the ways to go about things. You should just be natural and let whoever the hell he believes in, what's it, Xenu or whatever whatever the frig Scientology subscribes to, you know, just let it naturally heal. Okay, Tom, oops, I let my cancer fester inside my brain and now I have 3 months to live.
I just wonder that
vitamins and exercise. Screw you, Tom Cruise. Seriously, I'm glad that he's separated from Paramount.
Do you think that they did it out of a philosophical disagreement with him, or because, like they said, his behavior actually led to them losing money at the box office?
Did you see the box office for Mission Impossible 3?
Yeah, it made a whole bunch of money. No.
Not
that it did.
It didn't live up to what they had hoped for. Yeah.
Do you think that really affected it, or do you think it was just coincidence?
It has a part in it, man. Because, you know, people just, they don't trust him anymore. People want their movie stars to be people that they can say, wow, what a great guy. Yeah. Wow, that guy's a hero.
Right.
You know, he's supposed to, in a way, mirror the image that he has on the screen.
I wonder if it was just, if it was more a situation not so much of people, like, saying, oh, he's a wacko now, and, you know, I don't want to go see that movie, I don't like him anymore. I wonder if it was just a situation of, God, Tom Cruise, he's been on the TV every damn night, I don't want to go see that movie.
It's a combination. 2 hours. It's a combination of that.
Yeah.
That, and, you know, he's crazy.
Yeah, little Tom Cruise saturation, a little Tom Cruise insaneness.
Literally, little Tom Cruise.
Yeah.
He's like this big. But little Tommy Cruise, Tom, you're gone, and you screwed up big time.
So, I don't know. That's Summer Redstone, though. He's got a lot of balls. He's like a bazillionaire.
Yeah. Isn't he like 90-something years old?
Yeah, he's 90-something.
You know, he crawls out under a rock every 5 years and rattles his cane. Tom Cruise!
We'll have to see what happens to that. We know Brooke Shields was dancing a jig.
Right. Well, all right. How about this one, Barry? Right. You got your Tom Cruise on the one end. You got your Mel Gibson on the other, right?
Yeah.
And they're here. They're back and forth. If you were a producer and you had to pick one of those two to be the lead role in your film, at this point in time, who would you pick?
I honestly don't know.
You got to pick one, buddy. You're a big-time movie producer.
I'll say
one of these guys has a film in their contract, and you got to give it to him. One of them.
I'll say Gibson.
Mel. Because, you know, at least Mel is subscribing to something that a majority of the world does, which is Jesus Christ.
Well, right? Yeah, and that, and he apologized for saying what he said. Tom Cruise is proud of his crazy behavior.
Well, yeah, and of course with Mel, you got an affliction that a lot of people are you know,
yeah,
the alcoholism,
right?
You got the alcoholism, and you got the creepy Scientology,
right? Right.
Yeah. What are you going to pick? What are you going to pick, America? I say you pick the alcoholism.
Mel Gibson, yeah.
Because if you can't throw a few back, what kind of American are you anyway?
He's literally down to earth more than Tom Cruise.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So.
Tom Cruise just comes off looking like a jerk.
Yeah.
That whole comment, the comments he made about Brooke Shields.
Yeah.
You know, with her post...
postpartum depression.
Postpartum depression. He said, oh, you shouldn't be taking medication... Just let vitamins and exercise take care of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oops, I strangled my child. Stop telling people how to live their damn lives.
Speaking of movies, did you see Snakes on a Plane?
No.
You haven't seen it?
Too much hype.
Really?
It's internet hype.
Yeah.
I don't need to go pay $9 for...
I didn't. I torrented.
Here's Snakes on a Plane. Whoa! Get off the plane! It's Sam Jackson.
Yeah.
Get off the plane, you snakes!
Wait. Snakes on a cable TV set. A cable TV show set. Was that good?
That segment went horribly wrong. As the sweat beads off of your face.
If you didn't see it, I mean, I don't know. I torrented it. I didn't pay $9.
Yeah, I just don't have the time for that. It didn't look like something that would be worth my time.
I didn't
look like, you know, I watched the trailer and I got the overall gist of the movie.
Yeah.
Okay?
I hear you, yeah.
Just, I don't know.
It just became, for me, one of those things I had to see because everybody was talking about
exactly.
it.
Exactly. And you bought into the hype because you were a true consumer. I consider myself a film intellectual.
You're above the fray.
Right? I have to, you know, be into it. You know, and it did not grab me. It didn't. It's just hype. Hype.
Yeah.
Because how long did you hear about Snakes on a Plane?
Oh, too long.
Snakes on a Plane's coming out.
Yeah.
Snakes on a Plane. Why should I be concerned with Snakes on a Plane?
Yeah. I don't know. You can read my full review at our Voices in Your Head website, which is myspace.com/voicesinyourhead. I'll just say briefly, I wasn't blown away by it, but I thought it was a solid air disaster movie. You know, you've seen one air disaster movie, you've seen them all, basically, but this one, it was a solid air disaster film, and I thought the snakes were a means to an end, which is good, because they could have made it, like, overblown with snakes, and, you know, like,
I'll
about the snakes than the air disaster.
I'll take my Harrison Ford Air Force One versus Gary Oldman terrorist film any day. I'm the President of the United States!
That's right.
Get off my plane!
I haven't seen that one.
You never saw Air Force One?
I didn't see that, huh?
Harrison Ford, what a great American.
He is cool. Yeah.
Did you see him? He was in the audience at the Emmy Awards.
Was he?
He's looking more and more like your grandfather.
Yeah.
He's got the real thin gray hair. His nose is kind of red, probably due to alcoholism. You know,
that or Calista Flockhart.
He's next to Calista Flockhart, who just looks sickly.
You think?
Oh, her arm is like a walking skeleton.
I mean, I know she has looked sickly, but
she's a walking skeleton.
Really?
Looks horrible.
Because I looked at a picture today of her from the Emmys, and I didn't think so. I'll have to go back.
No. Han Solo should not be having sex with that. Han Solo likes his chicks maybe a little thicker.
Yeah.
Carrie Fisher wasn't the slimmest of women, mind you.
She looks like hell. Did you see her at the Shatner Roast?
I'll take a slightly overweight Carrie Fisher.
Yeah.
Than I will an emaciated, disgustingly skeleton-esque Calista Flockhart. Any day of the week.
Well, we're going to talk about the Shatner Roast.
You can bring that to the bank.
I will. We're going to talk about the Shatner Roast and the Emmys. But before we do that, before we close out on our snake business.
Yeah.
Did you hear about this? Did you hear about the mother snakes in the theater?
No, I didn't.
Okay. It was a wild Saturday night, apparently, in Phoenix, the weekend that the film opened.
Look at you. You're a regular Walter crying over here.
The Phoenix...
You got your news script. No teleprompters.
The Phoenix...
You can do it like this, Bart. You gotta look up sometimes.
Okay.
You gotta make the eye contact so the people can identify with your soul.
The apparently the Phoenix Police Department, they responded to a call.
Yeah.
That there was a snake in a movie theater in North Phoenix that weekend.
Coincidentally.
And it, yeah, and guess what movie it was showing?
I'll take a guess that it was Snakes on a Plane.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. So, yeah. So they were showing snakes on a plane. When the cops showed up, they found one 8-inch baby rattlesnake in the hallway. It was not actually in the theater.
Barry, you got to zip up your pants.
Yeah.
You can't be doing that. You saw what happened to Paul Rubens.
That's correct. I did.
Now he's, you know, where is his career at now?
I don't know.
He's not wearing the peewee suit anymore.
No. Now, there were rumors when this story hit that someone had released the snake into the theater. But the police are saying they think it probably just came from a construction area
nearby,
and they said that it was they corralled it. They turned it over to the Arizona Herpetological Association. I guess they're folks.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Herpetological.
Herpetological.
Is that
snake snake liking people,
or is it the study of herpes?
I don't know, but they say that they say that rattlesnake calls are not uncommon in the Phoenix area. And I guess the reports that the snake was intentionally put in there turned out to be not true.
Well,
just imagine.
Right.
You're in the Snakes on the Plane movie, and you see a snake.
Jesus.
In the theater.
Crazy. Well, Barry, anyway,
I give it 3.5 stars anyway. So.
With the movie?
Yeah.
Snakes itself?
Decent, yeah.
Thought it was decent?
Samuel Jackson.
I'll watch it when it comes to HBO. I'm not paying for it.
I hear you.
I'm not paying for it. And it's not worth my download.
Right.
I don't want to go to jail over Snakes on a Plane. My luck, I'll download Snakes on a Plane and, you know, the MPAA shows up at my door. Sir, that'll be a $500 fine for Snakes on a Plane.
The American people would not want to know any of the misquotes that George Bush may or may not make.
Right.
I disagree, sir. I hear you.
Did you see George W. Bush? He was on the nightly news talking to Brian Williams, and he says... You know, he's on vacation.
Yeah.
What are you doing on vacation, George? He's like, well, I'm reading. Yeah. Reading. Read me a few Shakespeare's. That's what he said. Shakespeare's. Like he just grabbed them out of a bucket.
The moron president.
A few Shakespeare's, you know. But he seems like a great guy. I'd love to go have a beer with him. And that's what's important when I'm electing the leader of the free world.
Of course.
Can I go have a beer with him?
So what do you think about the Emmys? Did you watch the Emmys?
Watched the Emmys.
I watched part of it.
Conan hosted. Yeah. Conan O'Brien.
Yeah, he was good.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
And of course, it's kind of going to get overshadowed by his, you know, the opening segment where they depicted a plane crash.
Which I thought was awesome, by the way.
Because they were alluding to the television show Lost.
Lost, yeah.
Which Barry and I are huge internet fanboys over.
We're going to talk about that soon, too.
Yeah. So yeah, the opening scene, he's going throughout... all the different television shows.
Right.
He's in Lost. Then he's talking to Jack Bauer.
Yeah.
Then
he was on The Office.
He's on The Office, and then he was in South Park. So it was a cool opening. And he comes on, and he had a little song and dance routine.
Yeah.
Where he had, like, one of those barbershop ads.
I fast-forwarded through that app.
Oh, man. Dude.
Watch the song and dance.
See, Conan's hilarious, dude. Yeah, I love that guy.
But what
happened? He's lanky.
He is lanky. But people were bitching about... The plane crash bit, because...
Yeah. Well, hours before that, there was a plane crash in Kentucky.
Yeah.
So,
49 out of 50 people on the
plane.
It
offended some people, but hey.
Yeah. You know what? They didn't even show the plane crash.
No.
They just showed him, like, knocking around inside the cabin.
Right.
And I was surprised when it first aired that the next thing you see is him getting out of the water.
Exactly.
You don't even see the crash.
Right.
Which is weird, because they have crash footage from Lost.
Right.
That they could have used, but they didn't.
You know, just...
So, but, and then people were upset.
Everybody's so sensitive.
NBC apologized today.
I know. I read the apology.
I mean, what the hell?
You got to be very careful not to offend people, Barry.
Yeah.
And that's why we're filming out of a basement.
Yeah.
On local access television. Because if we say we're on a CBS or a Fox...
Yeah.
We're going to offend everybody.
Really. What did you think of who won and who the nominees and all that stuff? Did you hear Jorge Garcia's comment when he's talking to Conan in the little skit?
No.
Conan lifts up the hatch thing and he's like, aren't you coming with me? I'm going to the Emmys. And Jorge goes, nah, dude, it's not like we were invited anyway. Well, because Lost wasn't nominated.
Right. There was no Lost nominated at all. Which, come on.
Yeah.
Great show. You got to nominate Lost.
Yeah.
I mean, the second season, not as good as the first,
right?
In my opinion, yeah. But still, right up here,
yeah,
man.
I mean,
right up there.
And not that 24 didn't deserve to win, even if it had been up against
it. It was 24's year. Here's what happened.
I don't watch that show, but I know it's quality.
Here's what happened. The Emmy panelists, or whoever votes on these things, they met, they said, look, we've kind of overlooked 24 the past 4 years.
Yeah.
All right? They kind of deserve an award. Let's just give them an Emmy for this season.
Yeah.
My opinion, the last season of 24 wasn't their strongest. Okay?
Yes, yeah.
But it's one of those cases where, well, I guess it's 24's year for us to recognize them.
Yeah. I hate when that happens, because they do that all the time.
Right.
Like the Lord of the Rings movies, they were nominated all 3 years, and they didn't win until the last one came out. And I think the reason that is because they said, I think that they sat down that same way and said, look, there are 2 more of these movies coming.
Right.
Let's give it to somebody else, and if we want to give it to them, we can give it to them in
Meanwhile,
the 3rd year.
The season where 24 should have won the Emmy was season 2.
Really?
The nuclear bomb.
How many
California,
seasons are they up to now?
They just completed 5.
Okay.
So season 6 will be back the upcoming season.
Yeah.
So great show. I mean, Kiefer Sutherland, I love that guy.
One of these years I'm going to have to get the DVD.
Jack Bauer, great character, 24, unbelievable series.
But I was just pissed that Lost wasn't nominated. Also, Desperate Housewives wasn't nominated.
Oh, dude, screw that show. Desperate Housewives. No. The second season blew.
You think?
Yeah, I think.
I don't know. Let's say the show doesn't get nominated. They still should have nominated Terry Hatcher.
She's another one of those skeleton queens.
Marsha Cross.
Terry Hatcher to have a few freaking cheeseburgers.
Marsha Cross should have been nominated. Felicity Huffman should have been nominated. There's no way that they should not have been nominated. They got raped, basically. Bent over the Academy Arts and Television, the Academy of Television Arts and Sciences desk and butt raped.
I disagree with you, sir. It's another hype show, Barry.
But the performances, that's a different thing altogether.
Right.
Like I said, even if you think the show, okay, overhyped and shouldn't have been nominated, but the acting is superb and those they should deserve.
Let me ask you this: have you ever watched the show Arrested Development?
No.
On Fox, unbelievable, hilarious.
Yeah.
The funniest. It was the funniest show on television. They did 3 seasons. One of the characters in it, Will Arnett, he was nominated for Best Supporting Actor in a Comedy Series,
yeah.
Which went to Tony Shalhoub.
Right.
But
that's a good show.
Yeah. That show, Arrested Development, so underrated. And they actually, Fox canceled it.
Yeah.
They canceled it. That's what happens nowadays.
Yeah.
You'll get a show highly critically acclaimed.
Yeah, then it doesn't.
It'll be on a couple of years. The critics will jerk off over it.
Yeah.
Watch this show. Watch this show. Watch this show.
And then nobody does. So, Kiefer Sutherland won for 24. 24 was Best Drama Series. Best Comedy Series went to The Office. Best Actress in a Comedy Series went to Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Right.
Again, up against the Marsha Cross or Felicity Huffman.
What show was Julia Louis-Dreyfus on?
The New Adventures of Old Christine.
Have you ever heard of that?
Yeah.
I've never heard of that.
I just, you know, it's a...
Is that still on the air?
Yeah. In fact, it's the only show in the that's still on the air.
Yeah!
Among the shows from which the other Best Actress in a Comedy Series actresses came from.
Okay.
Nominees came from. All the other shows that were represented by those actresses have been canceled.
But, I thought Julie Louis-Dreyfus looked hot.
Yeah.
Looked amazing.
Yeah. How old
is she?
I don't know. Mariska Hargitay looked good. The chick
Hargitay?
She just had a
That's
kid.
That's not the way you pronounce it. Want to try that again, buddy?
Hargitay.
There you go.
Mariska Hargitay.
Hargitay. Mariska
Hargitay.
Hargitay.
Her mother was a famous person.
Yeah, Jane Mansfield.
Correct.
Oh, my girlfriend and I, Mary and I, we love SVU.
Yeah, I like it.
We got the DVDs. We have the DVDs, I should say.
Yeah.
Proper English.
She looked good. You could still tell that she was recovering from having
Well,
had
she
a
just
child.
Had a kid this
yeah.
month, dude.
Yeah.
This month.
Yeah.
She'll get back in shape. She's
a pro. But she looked great.
Hot, huh?
Yeah.
She is hot.
The hair.
Love her.
Hot.
Mariska Hargitay.
She's hot. So that's a good show.
Baby.
That's the only one on here, that and Monk, that I wouldn't quibble with. Like, and Kiefer Sutherland 24, even though I haven't watched it, I know it's good.
You gotta get into it.
Yeah.
What I did with 24, I got all 5 seasons in a row.
Yeah.
Just watched them all in a month.
Right.
Boom, 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 boom. Before I had the current job that I have now, I was unemployed.
Yeah.
All I would do, I'd wake up around noontime and just fire off 5 episodes of 24.
Yeah.
Have a little lunch, some more 24.
I kind of did that when I was catching up on Lost and Desperate Housewives, except I torrented him.
So, you know how Neo in the Matrix learns things?
Yeah.
And they plug him in?
Yeah.
That was like me in 24. I was just like, Jack Bauer, Tony Almeida, Michelle Dessler. Yeah.
So the new TV season still hasn't started. It's not going to start this month for the most part, but Lost.
When's Lost coming back?
October.
Now, they're splitting the season up.
Yeah, which, you know, I guess they're going to do 6 weeks.
Okay.
And then they're going to show episodes of some other show until January.
Right.
Which kind of sucks, but once they come back in February, it's going to run through May with no repeats, no interruptions.
That's good, because something that sucked last year was, you know, you got your Lost, new episode, repeat.
Yeah, yeah.
New episode, repeat.
Yeah.
They broke it up. Yeah. It was hard to follow. That show's hard to follow anyway.
Yeah, and at first, I didn't think this was going to be much different.
Right.
Because I'm like, 6 weeks, and then another thing. What's the difference? Well, the difference is from January to May, no interruptions.
Exactly.
So that's good. Exactly. February to May.
That I like. That'll splitting it up, I can deal with.
Yeah. As opposed to the other, and when they're going to run a straight shot for 4 months, that'll be great.
That's what the new Battlestar Galactica did.
Yeah.
They ran how many? 6 episodes?
Yeah.
And then ran another 6 a few months
something
later?
Something like that, yeah.
Is that coming back in October?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yep. Dude.
Yep.
I'm fired up for that
season
one.
2, Doctor Who's going to be on.
Doctor Who.
It's really good.
I'm not in.
It's not by the British, this one. It's not a cheesy American one.
No.
It's good. Anyway. No. But Lost is on the cover of TV Guide this week.
Really?
Yeah, and there's a DVD with never-before-seen footage, previews of the third season, and they're saying that the third season is going to be less mythology-oriented.
Okay.
And more action-adventure-romance-oriented.
I like the mythology.
I know.
I don't like the sound of that.
They said
I don't like the sound of that.
They said, well, we might get to see some steamy scenes with, what's her name there?
I love how the mystery plays out.
Yeah.
And you gotta solve clues.
Yeah, they're gonna have some of that. They said mid-season is gonna be a huge bomb. They're gonna drop a huge bomb on us.
You dropped a bomb on me, baby.
Mid-third season.
Yeah.
So, we're looking forward to that.
So, alright, here we go. We're going to play a little Lost game right here, you ready?
Yeah.
Let's just, for all intents and purposes, say you're a homosexual.
Yeah.
You got your Jack, you got your Sawyer.
Yeah.
And,
I'm a few corpuscles gay anyway, my wife tells me, so.
Your Jack, your Sawyer, and who's the scruffy kid? Dominic Monaghan.
Yeah. Who is Charlie?
Get your Jack, your Sawyer, your Charlie.
Yeah.
You got to pick one to be your be your island gay fantasy partner.
Yeah. Jack.
Jack?
Yeah.
See, you sided with my girlfriend.
Yeah.
I'm more of a Sawyer guy.
You think?
I like that rugged, rough individual. He's a kind of a badass, and you know I like the bad boys.
Oh, okay. See, that's okay. My thing is, I can't deal with that. With he's too much of an asshole.
You need a nurturing individual.
Yeah, I need a guy.
Jack
yeah.
would be the kind of guy that would stroke your
self.
Silky hair and groom your beard. And
yes.
When you got too sweaty, he'd take a rag and wipe the sweat off your face.
As if we were a pair of Reese monkeys. Reese's monkeys. But yeah, so I'm a Jack, I'm thinking.
Nah, dude, Sawyer. And I want you to weigh in. We got to set up a poll.
Okay.
Can we do that?
Yeah, and I can do it on the MySpace page, I'm sure.
What's the website?
I shouldn't say I'm sure. I'm experimenting with MySpace. I'm getting good at it, but it's myspace.com/voicesinyourhead. We'll see if we can set up some kind of a poll.
Voices in your head?
It's actually voices in your head, excuse me.
So voices in Y-A. Y-A, because we couldn't get your.
Which is weird, because I tried that the other day, and whoever had it doesn't have it anymore, but you can't. Like, I can't. I don't know.
So myspace.com/voicesinyahead.
We'll put it up. I'll have it up on the screen.
You can do that?
Yeah.
Now, is there a way people can get a post and comment? And
oh, absolutely.
So if you're watching this and, you know, it's late on a Sunday, go check it out. Post on this episode. Say, you know, those two jack-offs, they suck.
Yeah.
Our tax dollars are going to this shit.
Yeah, that's what we'll do. I won't put up a poll per se, but, like, we'll have the poll question and then you can comment.
See if you can put up a poll if you
I'll
can.
Try.
I'll try.
I just was figuring out today.
What do you have to do?
I got the text that says tomizzo.org to become a hyperlink.
Hey!
I just got that to work today. So now visitors to the site don't have to cut and paste. They can just click right on that sucker. and go for some right into some Tom Izzo.
So yeah, for my weekly radio program that I do out of my basement, you can check out TomIzzo.org.
Right from the MySpace.
It's all podcasted on there. Everything's all set up. So all you need to do is go, click, and enjoy.
There you go. So,
you godless sodomites. That's my favorite line of the Emmys.
We want the poll to be, this is for male fans now, right?
Anybody.
Love, love.
Anybody.
Okay.
Anybody.
All right. So let us know. So that's that. But, let's do the wacky news and get that in there before, because I got a bunch of stuff.
Alrighty.
And I don't think we're going to get
Shall
to
Shall we do that? Okay.
But, what do you got there?
Well, Barry,
this is my favorite.
You like this one?
Yeah.
Get ready, Rhode Island. Strap in, because it's time for that. We should really have, like, a music bed for this.
I'll try to get one.
It won't happen. It will not happen. We're lucky if you can view the show in, what do we have, like, 6 colors on the screen?
Yeah.
We've got, like, dark gray, blue, gray, and brown, yellow. Our incandescent lighting. Yes. Yes, I'll ask you a bunch of questions. Stop filibustering! Just read it! Read the piece of paper I printed out for you! Okay, Barry. An Indian man born with 2 pennies.
No.
Oh, an Indian man. That's a blooper reel right there. Get Dick Clark on this one.
Dick Clark?
Dick Clark.
Dick Clark.
An Indian man born with 2 penises. Count them. 1, 2. It's got 2 cocks. Communications.
Yeah.
2 cable bills. And an Indian man born with 2 penises wants to get one of them removed so that he may marry, I guess, the new wife or the chick he wants to, doesn't like the 2 cocks.
Yeah.
That's a lot of work.
But how old is this guy?
I have a hard enough time getting 1 cock serviced. Whoa! Hey! Ho-ho! Ho-ho! Edit that part out! Woo!
Nah, I can leave it in. Yeah. So go
ahead. Yeah.
Does it say how old he is?
Yeah, he's 24 years old.
24 years with 2 woo-hoos.
24. He has 2 penises. He checked himself into a city hospital for the operation after having lived all his life with a rare condition. It's known as phallus.
I guess.
So di as in 2, and then phallus. 2 phalluses.
I wonder if they're both in the same place.
I don't know.
Does he have one coming out of his kneecap? Like, where
no,
is the
it's the same place. I think of it as kind of like a...
Yeah,
like that?
That's what I'm thinking.
Like a vagina?
Yeah, there was no picture on the...
What are you going to do? That's tough, man.
My 10-year-old son's reaction to this story... Excuse me, he's 12. My 12-year-old son's reaction to this story? 2 penises? Well, Dad, how's he going to bang a chick?
Obviously, he finds a girl with 2 vaginas. No, but I don't know, in a way...
Wait a minute, you're glossing over that, though.
Think about it.
My 12-year-old son asked me, how's he going to bang a chick?
How?
How's he going to bang a chick? I'm like, 12-year-old son, where did you learn the word phrase, bang a chick?
Well, he's probably heard of double penetration. Hello?
Maybe. I don't know. Okay, what were you going to say?
I was just going to say, it could be kind of awesome. Does that mean he has multiple orgasms?
I don't know. That's weird.
He must have to pay extra
when he
goes...
What happens when he has to pee? Does he have to put, like, a funnel?
Yeah, are there dual streams?
Yeah, what the hell happened?
And also, does he have to pay extra when he goes to get a prostitute?
I don't know.
Okay, $20 for 1 of your penises, and I guess if you want to throw in the other, that'll be an additional 5.
Oh, God. That's messed up.
But, yeah, you know, it's,
Notice this stuff is always in the third world countries.
Oh, yeah, always. All this crazy effed up crap is, it's like Ukraine.
Yeah.
India.
Yeah.
Uzbekistan.
Pakistan, yeah.
Because,
Pakistan.
You know, God knows what's floating around their atmosphere.
Yeah.
Nuclear particles and...
Well, Mattel has had some problems with sex. They're going to be suing over a lesbian Barbie show. Apparently... They are threatening to sue a Brazilian artist for portraying Barbie as a lesbian. Karen Schwartz's exposition features pictures of Barbie in compromising situations.
Right. Well, Barry, if I could interject.
Yeah.
Have you seen Ken without his clothes on? Doesn't have anything downstairs. I think he'd be a dykey broad as well. Hey, Ken, where's the cock?
Oh, God. They've given the artist 24 hours to close down the exhibition or they're going to take legal action. The artist says she's not going to back down. Barbie's exploited by Mattel. She wears
Fight
a,
it!
She wears a bikini. She shows off her belly. She has big breasts. She even has a boyfriend. So, like, in other words, they're exploiting her. So why is this suddenly...
Barbie should be a lesbian, wrong? In my opinion.
I don't know. This was at a bar in the city of Curitiba. And again, I don't know where in the world that is. But now, Mattel is saying Barbie's a very proper lady. And she's not happy about being portrayed as something that she
is. Oh, please.
Isn't.
Barbie's a whore.
Oh, absolutely she is.
Driving around in that little pink Corvette.
Yeah, but have you seen the clothes they put this chick in? I mean, there are dolls that are worse, like the brass dolls are much worse. But the clothes they put this chick in, I mean, come on. So, anyway.
It's
lesbian Barbie.
Yeah, absolutely. Barbie is a lesbian. Take that, Mattel.
There you go.
What are you going to do?
So, that's
you know who's not? You know who's very, very straight and who actually has quite a stunning action figure?
Who's that?
Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the USS Enterprise.
The Insurrection Edition.
Yeah.
The Insurrection.
You know, you gotta love Captain Picard. He's got the right idea. He's a bald man, and he just looks good, because he's bald throughout his entire life.
Yeah.
Bald with, you know, fair complexion.
Yeah.
That's the way to do it.
Yeah.
You never lose your hair if you're bald.
Right.
Love that guy.
We should announce, when we're talking about celebrities.
Yeah.
We should announce there's a Super Mega Fest coming once again. To,
Who's coming to this one?
Well, this one I'm actually excited about.
Last year, of course, was it
kind of
Who was there?
Kevin Sorbo.
Kevin Sorbo. He was
Chewbacca.
There. He had a crappy sweatshirt
Joyce
on.
DeWitt.
Joyce DeWitt of Three's Company. He was looking haggard.
This one's gonna be awesome. It's gonna be November 18th and 19th.
Oh, we gotta go.
Framingham Sheridan.
Right.
And they're gonna have Yvonne Craig, who of course played Batgirl.
What is she like? 100 years old?
Yeah. She played.
But there are bats flying out of her freaking panties now.
She played Batgirl in the 1960s Batman series. She also played an Orion Green Animal Woman on Star Trek.
Oh, really?
In a single episode, yeah.
That's a great one for the resume.
Jane Wedlin from the Go-Go's is going to be there. She was also on the Surreal World season 4.
Okay.
She's going to be there. Rowdy Piper.
Oh, yeah?
Will be there.
Yeah. All right.
And Elvira, Mistress of the Dark.
Sweet. I'm psyched about that.
Who is one of our friends on our page, by the way, Elvira.
Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Yep, it's gonna be there.
The Piper's Pit. You ever see that?
Yeah. Okay,
remember, you watch old wrestling, the
Absolutely.
'80s wrestling. That's
watch that all the time.
Awesome.
Saturday.
He would get so worked up. I'm gonna get you. I got my bagpipes on. Yeah, I'm gonna. Then he.
I just want to go up to him and say, "So why don't you take your face and make this a guess?"
Hogan, I'm gonna.
I just want to know when they're gonna make They Live 2.
I don't know. There's a movie where Roddy Piper's in. It's called Hell Comes to Frogtown.
Oh, yeah?
He goes to this society, and all the people in the society are frogs. And they talk, and they're, you know, they have human characteristics. And there ends up being a brutal civil war with Roddy Piper right in the middle of
the
action.
How did they render these frogs? Was it?
They were, I think they were like guys in cheesy-looking rubber frog suits. Awesome. You gotta see it.
Okay.
Greatest American act. Oh, no, he's Scottish, right? Is he actually Scottish?
No.
That's what Skate is.
No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
He doesn't have an accent in real life.
He
might be a
differ.
Scottish heritage.
I beg to differ. He's not No.
We'll see. We'll see when we go.
Barry, our award-winning show, it's going to look bad if he...
No. The awards are coming up again, you know, September 29th, and we're going to see if we're going to come away with anything.
Okay.
But, so that's happening. Super Mega Fest... And right on our MySpace page, you can check out the dates of the show and the
of
times,
course.
And there's
right.
you can find it there.
Last year,
so, yeah.
Voices in Your Head, your favorite public access variety entertainment news show, we went head to head in an unfair battle, I would say, with a Latin show called Catali Costa Hoy.
Yeah.
Catali Costa Hoy, and on the panel of judges. The majority of the judges were Latin!
We don't know this. I was supposing.
We got screwed.
Yeah.
So, this time, we're going to make sure that the judges, the panel, are stacked with regular, everyday white folks.
We can only hope. So, but, so that's coming up.
We can't lose to a Spanish program!
You can come down and see us. It's November 18th.
We could.
We'll talk about it again, and you can always
remind
yourself of the dates by checking out myspace.com/voicesinyourhead.
Right.
So, by the way, we're getting a lot of local hits. I say a lot, because to us, anything, even up to the single digits, is a lot. But We now have six friends on the page from the Rhode Island area.
Hey!
I have like 45 total, but we have six people from Rhode Island, a couple of bands that I've been checking out. Some bands
look
from
at us!
Some bands from out of state noticed our pages. Some people that went to school here but don't live here now came across us, and they're on there.
Well, Barry, we're moving right up.
It's cool. It's fun.
That's
it's a lot
right.
of fun. So definitely check out the MySpace page. I was working on it all day today. Got some funny South Park.
All videos. Day today.
All day.
All day.
All day.
You woke up. MySpace.
At the luggage store. That's what I did all day. I worked on the page.
Oh my God.
Some funny South Park videos on there. Some cool.
Great.
Stuff.
So you know out. The number one source I want to go to for South Park videos would be our effing website. How about getting videos of us up on there?
I know. I tried. I submitted one. They're supposedly still reviewing it. So, I gotta see.
But yeah!
A little earlier, Tommy, we were playing the Star Wars game.
Yeah, we had a little duel. A little Star Wars duel.
So, we were going to bring you a Star Wars duel a few months ago. We couldn't swing it. So, we sat down and we played.
We scoured for hours on end to try and find some cheap plastic lightsabers.
We couldn't
find a single one.
So here we bring you the next best thing Tommy and I are playing on the Xbox.
Well, Mr. Cook, time to pay.
And there are 10 jillion combinations.
It's fine.
I didn't bother to memorize it.
I show you the true power of the dark side.
Oh, yeah. Alright, let me pause it. These buttons, like, this one is a saber throw. You can throw it. And this one is like, for you, it's the electrical zap. I don't have that.
So
that's pretty much it. And, A is jump. And
X and Y is attack.
Yeah.
What's block? Attack?
Block is one of the triggers.
This one.
The left. The right one is,
attack.
No, the right trigger is, your force powers. Like, you can lift me up.
Okay.
And stuff. What else was I gonna tell you? That's pretty much it. Turn off.
There's something I want to show.
Obviously not Samuel Jackson. They do tie it up the screen at some point, so we can see that it's Darth Vader. Alright, so Tom here is playing Darth Vader with a red lightsaber.
I'm tired of these motherfucking snakes!
I will strike you down!
He just killed me.
Your death is inconsequential. I thought you'd do better than this.
But you've been playing this a long time.
Yeah, well,
you're my opponent? Is this a joke?
You can tell that's obviously not Samuel Jackson. What's weird though is at other times it is Samuel L.
Jackson. Oh yeah.
This is a motherfucking Jedi on a motherfucking ship.
Smell that much pain.
Yes! He killed me again!
You are no match for the dark side.
Well, that's it. Now we can play the match.
That was the first time I played.
That's fucked up.
It's because I have my Sith hood on.
It's all about the
hood.
We should say what we're playing. We're playing, Star Wars Episode 3 Revenge of the Sith, the video game on the Xbox. And we're in dual mode. When you finish the game, if you get enough points or whatever, you unlock like Darth Vader and the original Obi-Wan Kenobi, which I think I'm going to do now, is Ben Kenobi. And you can duel. It's pretty awesome.
You are no match for the dark side.
Yeah. All right, let's see if we can showcase some force power there.
We've got
in over your head, you know.
You have to
have much to learn.
You're going to hold that.
This time, now, you're only a master of evil paths.
No, I...
Obi-Wan's not supposed to have force control.
No, I lift him up. One of those random combos.
Come one.
It's a very cool game, though. The graphics are sweet.
So much. Got in over your head, you know. It's for your own good.
Oh. Well, you can heal by pushing down both sticks. Crap, you can heal if you hold down both sticks.
If it's coming out.
Sorry, I just remember.
How convenient.
Should have left you on that wing.
Check that game out. It's pretty cool. We're playing that on the Xbox, and you have an Xbox 360.
Well, I did.
I still get to get one. Yeah, what happened?
I did, but it was freaking working. Barry, one day I turned the game on, right, and on the system, these red lights just start going everywhere. Red lights are flashing at me.
Yeah.
Doesn't work now.
Not good.
Does not work.
So
I call up Xbox, and I said, listen, you sold me crap, okay? You sold me crap because it's not working. This is your fault. Clearly when these, you know, mine was one of the original batch of systems.
Yeah.
When these were manufactured, something wasn't right because many, many people had this same problem, right? Mine happened to break, of course, after the warranty date.
Oh, shit.
So they're like, sir, we'd be happy to fix this for you. for the sum of $139. So I say...
No way.
Yes way. I say, listen, you know, I already paid $400 for the system.
Yeah.
This, it's not like, you know, I spilled Mountain Dew Code Red on my system, right? Take care of my kids. I take care of my systems.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, you know, I kept pushing them and pushing them. And they said, well, I guess we could take 25% off. I'm like, how about you do it for 100% off?
Yeah.
How about that, you jackasses?
Unbelievable.
So now I have a broken Xbox and my gaming dreams are shattered for now. I know I'll end up paying the 90 or whatever because... You know, I can't go without my gaming.
I hear you. That's so absurd. You know, why bother to have a warranty at all? They make a product.
It's a 90-day warranty.
Yeah, I know, but everybody does that. All the electronics. They make a product that auspiciously could last 15 years.
Right.
You know, you buy a TV, it's supposed to last 10 years.
More, if not more.
Yeah. 90 days they give you on the warranty? I mean,
they give you a
90-day
warranty.
If you buy a product that's supposed to last 10 years... The warranty should be good for 2 years, at least.
Exactly. You know? And, you know...
Why bother 90 days?
And if you make a product that, you know, the first batch off the assembly line is flawed...
Yeah. There should be no questions
asked.
There
should be no issue.
Anything
there should be,
from
sir,
that batch, right.
Your Xbox is in the mail.
Yeah.
You're getting... Right. Your new one is right in the mail.
I agree. 90 days is like a period of a warranty you should give on something that's supposed to last a year and a half.
Right. It's ridiculous.
It's just ridiculous.
And of course it breaks, you know, 2 or 3 days after the warranty.
Yeah.
So shame on you, Microsoft.
Crazy.
You know...
I'm still holding out for that price drop. Anyway, the only thing we got to talk about... Did you watch the Shatner roast?
I've seen bits and pieces
of it. It was terrible.
You think? I don't
terrible.
Think so.
I mean, I laughed a lot, but so. Did you see the Pam Anderson roast?
Yeah.
I thought the Pam Anderson roast was much.
No, dude, George Takei, come on, that was hilarious.
Yeah, he was funny. But you know what? I don't think he wrote that.
Still, man, anything George Takei, yeah. I'll buy. George, you release George Takei products, I'm buying them. Anything.
I thought they spent too much time lambasting each other and not enough time. I mean, I know they're supposed to do that.
Shatner coming out on a white horse.
That was cool.
Brilliant.
And then Takei says, "Fuck you and the horse you rode in on." That was funny.
Oh my. But, I love them.
I thought they spent too much time doing it to each other. Like, on the Pam Anderson roast, they did the same thing. They picked on everybody, but it wasn't so much on everybody. Well, it was more on Pam.
Did you see what happened backstage?
Andy Dick was
licking people and
yeah.
biting people.
He's screwed in the head, that guy.
What's that guy's deal?
I don't know. He's not
right. Avoid Andy Dick. There's something not right.
The boy ain't right. So.
But, I dug the Shatner roast.
Yeah, I thought it was funny. I mean, my favorite one was when that guy goes, and by the way, excuse me, settle a bet between a friend of mine and me. Could you act your way out of that real quick? And he opens up the paper bag. That was cool. And I thought, Betty White was funny. So.
Sure.
But, like, where was, Candace Bergen? Where was, the other guy there from Boston Legal?
Hmm.
You know?
My thing, my only issue that I take with Comedy Central and their roasts, and I understand they have a contract with the Friars Club, but these roasts, why can't they be put on at like an HBO or a Showtime?
So you can have
that. I hate the censorship, man.
Yeah.
I hate it.
To get the DVD.
They release DVDs uncensored?
Yeah.
That's cool.
So.
Who, by the way, looks horrible without makeup.
Yeah, she does.
Have you ever seen her without her makeup on?
Not good.
Not good. Not pretty.
Yeah, she looks alright in minimal makeup, but totally sans makeup.
Yeah, and those balloons, they're starting to get a little...
Yeah.
I don't know. What are you going to do? That's time for you. On the Emmys, did you see the Charlie's Angels come out?
No.
Farrah Fawcett, Jacqueline Smith, and...
No, I totally
Who's the
that.
Other one?
Kate Jackson.
Farrah Fawcett. Has not only hit the wall, but she jumped off a bridge onto the wall. Yeah. Oh. Oh.
I don't know.
Oh, my. And what a shame, because she was so beautiful in her day. And
she was.
It's just...
I had that poster, you know.
It's so unfortunate
you
when...
You know that poster?
Yeah.
I had it. I used to do that.
But
used to run home after
it's
school.
So unfortunate, especially for, you know, if you're a female celebrity and you're known for your looks.
Yeah.
You should just
I
get
think
you
she
should
looks
just
all right personally. But.
After you're done and you're starting to lose your looks, just stay off camera.
Yeah.
Cuz it's sad. She's clinging and, you know, she's yeah. got tons of makeup on and
yeah. Well, she was on the Shatner roast.
Yeah.
So that's really it. We'll be back in October. We're going to go to the Super Mega Fest in November.
Award-winning Voices in Your Head.
Hopefully twice by the time you see us again.
You're going down Catali Costa Hoy. You're going straight down.
And visit myspace.com/voiceinyourhead. A lot of cool stuff on there. Cool friends. You can link right to William Shatner's page on MySpace. And he actually interacts with people. He writes his own blog and stuff. Some of the celebrities don't. Like Kelly Osbourne, Paris Hilton. Their sites, they don't actually interact. But Shatner does. Hal Sparks does.
Of course he does. He's a good man. Bit of an ego, but...
Yeah. There's, who else?
Yeah. BarryCook.com.
let's see. I have other celebrities on there.
When are you going to L.A.?
I can't think of it. I don't know. I want to go one of these years.
We're making a Barry Cook film. Barry P. Cook in Hollywood or something like
that. If I ever go to Hollywood, I'll wind up on here. I'll be one of the celebrities that ends up getting arrested, like Ozzy Osbourne.
Caught, you know, whacking it in a theater.
Billy Joe Armstrong, Jack White.
No, you know who you're going to be? Where is he? I know he's on here. Where's Paul Rubens?
He's not on here.
He's not on here?
No.
You kidding me? There's no Paul Rubens mugshot?
No.
And he should be there.
We got Jesse Jackson, Eminem.
Now, my question is,
Mean Bleef.
Before we end, before
yeah.
we go,
yeah.
if you ever look at the Paul Rubens, Pee Wee Herman mugshot,
yeah.
Full mullet.
Yeah.
Giant glasses.
Yeah, yeah.
White t-shirt.
Goatee.
He looks goatee. Looks like a total redneck.
Yeah. yeah.
Looks like a total truck driving, beer swilling redneck. You see him in interviews and on television. He was on Letterman recently.
Yeah, the other night, yeah.
He's so effeminate.
Yeah.
What was that period in his life where he was like, I'm gonna have a mullet? What was that? Put that mugshot, if you can, up, and then try to get a recent photo.
Okay.
Like on a Letterman. He's
well, contrasting.
I think it's fair to project that he might be a homosexual at this point.
Think that's a possibility?
Yes! Okay. Jumpy!
So on that note, we'll sign out. We'll be here in October.
Of a Halloween special.
Yes, and bring out the skull light.
Skull epic on camera.
And yeah. So, there we go. So, have a good one.